In this video, I will show you how to configure the XFC4 desktop to be able to use our Linux environment as a real environment. We will also see how to install a number of programs such as Chromium or VS Code so you can use your Android device as if it were a full PC. I leave you with a small preview of what we are going to do throughout this video. I hope you like it. I will give you two options to have this desktop with everything already installed. On the one hand, I will leave the link to the backup file in the description of the video so you can download it and you can restore it directly as you are seeing. This is the fastest and most direct way, but I advise you to watch the whole video. On the other hand, if you want to learn how to install and configure everything step by step, just follow the video. Let's start from the last video I made on how to install Linux and use Termux X11. The first thing will be to start the newly installed XFC4 desktop with the script from my GitHub. I leave the link in the description. We open Termux X11 and wait for the desktop environment to load. The first thing we are going to do is to install a terminal that is more beautiful and to which we can apply the customization themes that we are going to use later. If we go now to the Applications menu, inside System, we will see that we have the new terminal called XFC Terminal. Now we are going to install Chromium, a web browser that in my experience works much better than Firefox in terms of performance. The only thing is that to launch it we have to use the no sandbox parameter as you can see in the terminal. Once we have installed the browser, we are going to look for a customization theme to apply to the desktop. In this case, I like one called Sweet Theme. We enter the first link that appears in the search, but I also leave it here in the description of the video. We go to the Releases section and select the variant that we prefer. Now I will select the file called Sweet Amber, but later I will change it to Sweet Dark because I prefer dark themes. Once we have downloaded the zip file, we are going to unzip it. To do this, we install the tool called unzip and enter the command you see on the screen. Next, we have to copy the unzipped folder to a specific path. We cut the folder and we go to the home path. We enable to see the hidden files in the file explorer. We proceed to create a folder called .themes. We paste the unzipped folder here. If we want to apply the theme we just downloaded, we have to go to the Applications menu, then to Settings and Appearance. As you can see, the appearance of the desktop is already changing. We also have to apply these changes to the Windows. To do this, we go to Applications, Settings, and Windows Manager, and select the theme we have downloaded. With these changes, the customization is taking shape. Now I am going to repeat the process in fast motion, but with the sweet dark theme, since I prefer a dark theme instead of a light one. Now we are going to change the icons. For this, we go to the xfclook.org page. In this page, you can find a lot of themes, icons, and so on for the most popular Linux desktops, but especially for XFCE4. We look for the icon pack called Candy. Click on the download button and wait 10 seconds. Unzip the file we just downloaded. As it is in tar XE format, we will use the command you see on the screen. Copy the folder and put it in a new folder called .icons, just where we created the themes folder before. Go back to the appearance settings and select the new icon pack. As you can see, the new icons have already been applied, but not all of them have been updated yet. So that the icon that I point out of the bar below is updated, we are going to close and open Termux again. Let's make sure that everything is properly closed so that no processes are left open. We run the script again to launch the Termux X11 desktop. We can check that the missing icon has been updated. If we want, we can deactivate the view of hidden elements of the file explorer. Now I am going to show you how to customize the panel below to put the elements that we want. Right-click on the panel and go to Panel Preferences. We go to the Items tab, and we are going to change the behavior of the browser icon to open Chromium instead of Firefox, which is the default. For it, we give to the icon of adjustments, we erase the one that there is, and we add Chromium. It is important that we add to the launch parameters the no sandbox, or the browser will not open. You can see how now the icon in the lower panel opens Chromium directly. Now that we have opened the browser, we are going to install VS Code to be able to program. I leave you a video where I explain how to do it step by step. Basically, we download the package for ARM architecture and install it with the command you see on the screen. Let's add the direct link to VS Code in the bottom bar. It is important that we add the no sandbox parameter as we did in Chromium. We are also going to change the direct link to the terminal to use the one we installed at the beginning of the video. Now we are going to customize the terminal a little bit, although later I will show you how to apply other color schemes. We are going to install the LSD tool to make the terminal more attractive when we do the LS command. We are also going to install the ZSH shell to be able to install the power level 10K theme as we saw in the Termux customization video. We simply copy and paste the install command. Now let's install the power level 10K theme in the same way. We modify the ZSH configuration file and tell it to use the theme we just installed. We close and open the terminal again to apply the changes. We can see that there is a problem, and it is that we do not have installed any font that we can use to display the icons offered by Power Level 10K, so we are going to solve it. Let's go to the following link. I leave it in the description. We copy it and paste it in the terminal. We choose the font we want to install. In my case, I am going to install the one called Pack. Close and open the terminal again. Select in the appearance settings the new font. Run ZSH and perform the configuration steps as we have already seen in previous videos. You only have to follow the installer and go answering to your liking. I made a mistake when configuring the terminal, so I am going to show you the process of rerunning the Power Level 10K installer. You just have to run the command you see on the screen and follow the same steps as before. Now we are going to create the alias for the LSD program that we installed earlier. We edit the ZSH configuration file and add a new alias. For the changes to take effect, we have to restart the terminal. We are also going to make the terminal use ZSH instead of bash by default. To do this, we go to the terminal settings, and in the run a custom command section, we set ZSH. If we open the terminal, ZSH opens directly. Next, we are going to put a wallpaper that goes with the theme that we have so far. Everything is practically configured, and as you can see, I think it looks pretty good. However, we can improve the colors of the terminal. To do this, we will go to the link that you see, and that I leave also in the description. We choose the color palette that we like, in this case the number 146, and apply the changes. With this, we have our environment completely configured. I hope you liked it, and do not hesitate to share your creations for other users to take ideas for your own desktops.